Before we introduce tonight's entertainment, I'd like to turn the program back over to Rob and previous conference chairs Phil Miller and Don Henderson for a special announcement. So Rob and Phil and Don, please take the stage.
Thank you, Jim. As I mentioned earlier tonight, the SaaS user community has always led the way in innovation. We've also always enjoyed getting together here at our annual conference and at the regional conferences throughout the year. At one of our SaaS Global User Group board meetings, we realized we needed a way for SaaS users around the world to meet and discuss issues regarding SaaS software anytime or anywhere. In this age of blogs, wikis, online social interaction, and Web 2.0, the time is right and the technology is in place for us to develop a true SaaS community. A community that knows no geographic boundaries, that is user-run, is open 24/7, and is accessible by everyone who has an interest in SaaS. So tonight, it is my distinct honor to be able to officially announce SaaSCommunity.org. Phil, could you please show us a few of the features of SaaSCommunity.org?
As Rob said, we are looking at all of the latest technologies and trends in social interaction communities and incorporating the best of breed. So here is the homepage of SaaSCommunity.org.
And as you can see, there are lots of different ways for you to interact with this community, and that will change as the community evolves and grows.
One of the features that we think will be very popular is the SaaSipedia, where users can contribute and share their technical insights about SaaS software. Let's drill down a bit and take a look at a particular topic, numeric representation issues in SaaS.
And one of the really nice features of this new Web 2.0 technology is that I can specify that I want to watch a page. That way I'm updated or notified whenever the page is changed.
That's really an important consideration of collaborative sites like Wikipedia. You, out there in the user community, can be the experts watching over topics that are of particular interest to you and make sure that the information is accurate. So here you see an example of a watch list.
So for example, if the Toronto Users Group has a page on a site, I can watch it so I'm notified whenever they update it with details about their next meeting.
Yeah, Rob, you're absolutely right. And along the lines of what Guy was just talking about, this is really a curve jump. We can make mailing lists obsolete. Instead of users being on a mailing list, they can select a page to be watched, and then they're notified when the page is changed, and they have control over how they're notified.
Great. Let's look at some of the blogging areas of the site.
Here's what we call the Blogger's Corner, which lists the blogs that people are writing.
Right, and we can see that there's even one about SaaS in developing countries.
Remember, global access is one of the main goals we are trying to accomplish. Unfortunately, we can't show all of the features here tonight, but the site will be available throughout the conference in the demo area and on the internet. So stop by and kick the tires while you're here and tell us what you think.
Yes, and we've even added some help pages on the site to assist users in understanding this new model. We have a page that talks about how to organize articles. There's even a Talk to Us link on the main menu where users can provide feedback to each other and to us about the site.
The entire executive board has been involved in this effort, but Don, you and Phil have been very actively involved designing and working with some other SaaS users to build this site. Can you tell us how far the site has evolved?
Sure. We started working on this project in November of 2006, and Dr. Goodnight was good enough to lend us some resources, and he's also generously agreed to host the site. We've been working very hard to make this site available here at SaaS Global Forum, and I'm really happy on behalf of the entire executive board of the SaaS Global Users Group that the site is up and running now, and you can access it at www.saascommunity.org. But as Phil mentioned, we'd really like for you to try it out. It's going to be available on the message center machines. It's available in your room via the internet. This is your community. It's up to all of you out in the audience and all SaaS users to make sure it meets your needs. So please get involved. Give us your feedback. You can give us your feedback here in the demo room at the conference, or even better yet, on the site itself.
Thanks, Don. You'll notice that all of the executive board members are wearing green ribbons. So feel free to stop by, let us know any of your thoughts. I think this is also an excellent environment for SaaS users to let us know what we can do better as your user group executive board, to provide you with the means to communicate with us on a regular basis. Jim, on behalf of the entire SaaS community, we want to thank you for your involvement, for committing resources, and for agreeing to host the site for SaaS community.
Well, thank you, Rob. The site really does look good, and I admire the work that you guys have done. But I think it is important to emphasize the fact that it's your site. SaaS is delighted to be involved and will participate along with you as members of the community. We built SaaS on a simple principle of listening to our users and providing high-quality software that will meet your needs. SaaScommunity.org will be a great new way for us to keep that dialogue alive, and we're very excited to be a part of it.
Thanks again for your support.